Hi friends, in this video we see about simple harmonic motion. The simple harmonic motion is under the motion of oscillatory motion. Okay, so first we see about what is oscillatory motion. So oscillatory motion means that is back and forth motion about a mean positions. Okay, so or we can define if your body moves back and forth repeatedly about a mean position, that is equilibrium position, it is said to oscillatory motion. Okay, sometimes this oscillation can be expressed in terms of simple harmonic function like sine or cosine function. That is, the oscillation can be expressed as sine or cos. Okay, so next one, what is simple harmonic motion? Okay, so a harmonic oscillation of constant amplitude. So amplitude means a particle reaches a maximum displacement, maximum displacement about its mean positions or equilibrium position, it is said to be amplitude. Okay, so a harmonic oscillation of constant amplitude and a single frequency is called simple harmonic motion. Okay, that is SHM. Now we consider one particle. The particle is said, when we said that is a simple harmonic motion. Okay, so a particle is said to execute simple harmonic motion if its acceleration is directly proportional to the displacement. Okay, that is the acceleration A is directly proportional to the displacement Y. Okay, so A is proportional to Y. To remove the proportionality, we add one constant. Okay, so that constant is here omega squared. So A equal to minus omega squared Y. Okay, so here negative sign is there. So negative sign indicates the acceleration A is opposite to the displacement Y. Okay, so A is acceleration is opposite to displacement. So we put negative sign. So the acceleration of simple harmonic motion is A equal to minus omega squared Y. Okay, so the omega is the angular frequency of the simple harmonic motion. Now we write what is force. Okay, so the force F equal to, we already known that force F equal to F equal to ma, isn't it, mass into acceleration. Okay, so here the value of acceleration is minus omega squared Y. So we can write F equal to minus m omega squared Y. Okay, so F equal to we write minus k y. Here k is m omega squared. Okay, so we call k is the force constant or spring constant. Okay, k is called the force constant or spring constant. The value of k is k equal to m omega squared. Here the unit of force is n m minus 1 newton meter minus 1. Okay. Next one, the example for simple harmonic motion is the projection of particle uniform circular motion on a diameter is simple harmonic motion. Okay, consider a particle moving along a circumference of a circle of radius A and center O with uniform velocity V in anti-clockwise direction. Let x, x dash and y, y dash be the two perpendicular diameters. Okay, so suppose the particle is at P after time t. Okay, so after 5 minutes or 10 minutes, the particle moves and it reaches the point at P. Okay, now if omega is the angular velocity, okay, then the angular displacement theta in time t is given by theta equal to omega t. Okay, so the particle is moving. So we calculate the angular displacement theta equal to omega t. Okay, so from P draw PN perpendicular to y, y dash. Okay, as the particle moves from x to y, foot on the perpendicular, N moves from O to y. Okay, so as it moves further from y to x dash, then from x dash to y dash and back again to x. The point N moves from y to O and O to y dash and back again to O. Okay, so when the particle completes one revolution along the circumference, the point N completes one vibration about the mean position O. The motion of point N along the diameter y dash is symbol harmonic. Hence, the projection of a uniform circular motion on a diameter is symbol harmonic motion. Okay, so here we write the displacement, that is the distance travelled by the vibrating particle at any instant of time t from its mean position is known as the displacement. When the particle is at P, the displacement of the particle y is written as, that is y is the displacement of the particle. Okay, so y is written as y equal to a sine omega t. Here a is the amplitude. Okay, so the amplitude of the vibrating particle is defined as its maximum displacement from the mean position. Next one, we calculate the velocity. So velocity is the rate of change of displacement. Okay, so the rate of change of displacement is the velocity of the particle. So y equal to a sin omega t, is it? So from this we calculate velocity equal to omega root of a squared minus omega squared. Okay, that like acceleration in SHM, that is acceleration of a symbol harmonic motion. So the acceleration is the rate of change of velocity. Okay, so we can write acceleration equal to minus omega squared y. Okay, here minus sign indicates the acceleration is always opposite the displacement. Okay, and is directed towards the center. Next one, we see about some important terms related to symbol harmonic motion. Okay, so first one is time period. Time period means that is the time taken by the particle to complete one oscillation. Okay, so time period means it is the time taken by a particle to complete one oscillation. That is, we write capital T equal to 2 pi by omega. Okay, so here we write the displacement of the particle executing symbol harmonic motion. So this can be written as in terms of sine and cos theta, that is y of t. Okay, so that is at a time t, it is function of time. Okay, so y of t equal to a sine t pi by 2 pi t t, then y t equal to a cos 2 pi by capital T into d. Okay, that is sine a sine omega t, isn't it? Y equal to a sine omega t, but omega equal to 2 pi by t. Okay, substitute the value of omega, so we get y of t equal to a sine 2 pi by t into t, then y of t equal to a cos 2 pi by t into t. Okay, so in general we can write, that means this function, these two functions repeat when t is repeated by t plus capital T. Okay, so we can write the displacement y of t small t plus n capital T equal to y of t. Okay, so the next one is frequency and angular frequency. Okay, so here the number of oscillation produced by the body in 1 second is known as the frequency. It is expressed by n. Okay, so in one set, the number of oscillation, frequency means the number of oscillation produced by the body in 1 second. Okay, so the time period to complete one oscillation is 1 by n. Okay, so t equal to 1 by n, that is time period is the reciprocal of the frequency. So we can write t equal to 1 by n. So the, here the frequency units heads and omega is the angular frequency. The value of angular frequency is 2 pi n. Okay, so this angular frequency is expressed in radian second minus 1. Okay, so next one, phase. The phase of the particle vibrating in symbol harmonic motion is the state of the particle as regard to its direction of motion and position at any instant of time. Okay, so we write the phase y equal to a sine a sine omega t plus pi naught. The term omega t plus pi naught equal to pi. That is the phase. Okay, is known as the phase of the vibrating particle. Okay, so the displacement y equal to a sine omega t. Here we add displacement y equal to a sine omega t plus pi naught. So omega t plus pi naught is known as the phase of the vibrating particle. Okay, so the next one, example of simple harmonic motion. Okay, the first example is horizontal and vertical oscillation of a loaded spring, and the second one is vertical oscillation of water in a tube, and the third one is oscillation of a floating cylinder, then fourth one is oscillation of a simple pendulum, and fifth one is vibration of the frogs of a tuning fork. Okay, these are the example of the simple harmonic motions. Okay, so thank you friends, that's